In this example, we're going to calculate linear density and planar density for iron. Iron has the body center cubic structure. We're going to calculate the linear density along the 100 direction and the planar density for the 100 plane. So I've indicated the 100 direction. Which axis I call X is arbitrary when we have this cubic structure. We'll get the same answer if I picked one of the other axes as X. Linear density, atoms per length, whose centers are on the direction vector. So if I look at the 100 direction, then this atom and this atom are on this vector. And so for the distance of the unit cell, so let's call this distance A, which of course then is the length of all of the sides of this unit cell. Distance A, I have half of this atom and half of this atom. So I have a total of one atom per distance A. And so if I can determine the distance A relative to the radius of the atoms, and keep in mind this is not a space-filling model. I've indicated the lighter color blue atoms as the corner atoms, and this darker blue one is then the center atom in the body center cubic structure. And of course in the structure, in a space-filling model, the center atom touches all of these other atoms I've indicated here. So let's look at using geometry to determine distances. I can look at the diagonal going from this atom to this atom, and I could represent that as, in a space-filling model, three atoms. Here's the corner here. This is the atom on this corner. This now is the center atom. And so this distance, R, where R is the atomic radius, this distance is 4R. So what I want to do is use geometry and draw a triangle that will allow me to calculate A from this value R. I have a diagonal going from these corners. I can now have one length of the triangle as this side, which is length A. And then the last would be this diagonal. And I'll call that for now B. Draw this so it's a little clearer. So I know A squared plus B squared is equal to 4R squared. I have to first calculate B. So if I look at the triangle that relates A and B, so just look at this front face where A, the side A, the diagonal B. A squared plus A squared is equal to B squared. So I can then solve this to determine B. So what I'm going to do is substitute B back into this equation. And so I've just reduced this to solve for A in terms of R. And then I can look up R, property of the atomic radius of iron from a periodic table, which means I have now a value for A. So once I have the dimension for A, there's one atom per distance A, which means the linear density is 2.52 atoms per nanometer. So this is the linear density for iron along the 100 direction. Second part of the problem is to calculate the planar density for the 100 plane. So if I look at the x-axis again in this direction, then the plane we're talking about is this plane here. Intercept x is 1, it does not intercept the y and z axis. And we want the number of atoms per area. So we look at this plane, each of these atoms is shared with the cube in the plane now. So it means we have 4 atoms, but only 1/4 is associated with this particular square that I've drawn here. And the area is just a squared. So I have 1 atom, and the area is 0.397 nanometers squared. So this is 6.34 atoms per nanometer squared, and that's the planar density for iron for the 100 plane.